I don't understand your hesitation. It's Valentine's Day, and that is a Valentine's Day gift, ergo.
This is a Valentine's Day gift from Coop. And now he's dead, and we're on the trail of his killer.
Right, and all circumstantial evidence keeps pointing to the crabby commando.
I'm really sorry, but I have to stay strong and focused, and if I open that gift, I'm gonna start crying for Coop and Georgie, and I might never stop.
All right, well then, by all means, stay strong. But I, one lesson away from completing my course to become Jackal PI, must away. Stone Cold is expecting my cyberistic aid on some important but somewhat mysterious mission. The private investigatory grasshopper was held up greatly by the wounded blonde one in her.
Any idea what you've just done?
1001 pardons to Stone Cold and Vixenella. I had no idea the master was entertaining.
What are you?
Jackal? Internet? Cyberspace?
Well, you need to get out of your room more. Hey, what about our bet? Double or nothing.
Maybe some other time. Did you get the address I wanted? Did you get the address I wanted?
You know, Stone Cold, the Jackal has exhibited nothing less than Sherlockian wisdom and patience while dealing with the wise Georgie's sister, and also trying to find the real identity of the text message killer. Oh, 78963? Which lesson 14 of my online PI course clearly states is a necessity.
Does it mention anything about being quiet?
Indeed it does.
Okay, try that.
Try 36975? But if I may be so bold as to speak once more.
What?
Who is the, nocturnal temptress that was aching for a dance with the master?
Someone looking for a good time, okay? She actually kind of bugged me, so I hope I don't run into her again. Okay, we need this green light to go on, Spinelli. Keep looking for a combination that works.
You know, the Jackal did find it interesting to be subjected to the innermost workings of the wounded blonde one's thinking process. I mean, it is simplistic and illogical, but somehow somewhat productive and practical. 93191. You know, Logan remains our person of interest given the clues that we've amassed. 77777.
You know what? Maybe you should have brought Maxie.
Right. You know, the first thing that she would have done was abandon all understanding of mechanical devices and entry codes and probably just tried the door and walked in. Sam.
I have to warn you, but keep in mind, there's no solid proof yet.
The text message killer is still out there and Coop didn't do it. I think I already told you that.
There may have been someone out at Alexis's house tonight. Kristina saw something.
I think Coop was close to figuring it out too. That's why he died. He got this for me.
I'm so sorry.
I want to see him cleared.
I want to see you get past this.
I lost Jesse and Coop and my sister and my mom.
Your mother is still alive.
Not to me. I don't even have my own heart.
Why don't you open that? Coop asked me weeks ago what I thought he might like.
You'll always have a heart to fall back on. Mine. I love you, Coop.
Hey,
funny Valentine. Sweet comic Valentine. You make me smile.
My mission with Stone Cold is accomplished.
Okay, well, Mac was here. And someone was out at Alexis's lake house, most likely after her.
Did you mention our suspicion about the Krabby Commando?
No, Scott Baldwin's on the case, and who knows what he would do to cover up his son's guilt. We have to be careful, Spinelli, and get some real evidence against him.
And soon, Jack OPI is noticing a disturbing pattern in the killer's behavior. It's only logical. The extra attempts made on the fair Samantha and her goddess mother suggest that it's not only what the victims have in common with each other, it's what the killer has in common with the victims. Thank you.